Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today we are going to understand about Tesca's DC position control kit. In this kit, we are understanding the basic concept of forward back feedback control system in the second order of DC position control. Through this kit, we will control the position control of a DC motor by providing the feedback through an tacho generator and also provide gain and control the signals for a DC position control. So this is our trainer kit to perform the DC position control with this DC motor. The order code for this trainer kit is 19204149.70. So by this order code you can find out the specification and you can also purchase this kit by visiting through our website, which is www.tesca.in. So now I will explain you the different circuitry of this trainer kit. So this is the basic control loop, open loop and control loop circuit, which is printed over here in this trainer kit. So we will start with this power on off switch. So the power on off switch is provided at the back side of this kit, on the top side or front side. And this is the power connector here, and this is the power on off switch. By this, power can be on and off for this kit. So this is the power LED presented here. So this LED will start or glowing when the power is on. This is the step input switch, simple toggle switch for on and off the step input. At this point this is the voltage for step input, can be measured through connecting patch cord here, and this is the reference voltage. So the potentiometer for 0 to 30 degree, 360 degree movable potentiometer is provided for reference voltages of different ranges. So when we provide step input and reference input, both the input will be combined at this point, and this will be the forward gain potentiometer. So the forward gain can be changes from 0 to 10. This is the range. The P1 potentiometer is used for the forward gain. This is the driver which compare and calculate both the signals for reference and step inputs. Now this is the basic description of motor unit and tacho generator unit, which is provided in the motor section. We will discuss it about later. So the tacho generator output will be combining with this tacho gain. So this will be represented as KD and this will be represented as KA. This is the forward gain and this is the tacho gain. Tacho gain will be, can be changes to 0 to 1. So this will be the tacho gain, and the output can be, output voltage can be calculated from this V0 point here, and this will be provided via closed loop system of a controlling motor unit, DC control. Now this is the DPM which shows the input voltage of the different locations. From different location we can see the input voltages at this voltmeter, and this is the section for waveform generator. As we know, this is the step inputs and different inputs, and calculations of control system cannot be easily obtained and at the CRO, as they are not analog and digital signal properly. So there is a waveform generator card is inserted in this, which will be calculate the waveform, and that will be shows at X and Y in the XY mode on the CRO. So this is the display LED and this is the capture LED. The working of this LED I will explain later, and this is the mode switch and this is the reset switch to reset and change the mode of display to capture. Capturing, at the capturing mode, the waveform will be captured, the card automatically capture the LED, capture the waveform and give the output. And this at the display mode, when we after capturing, the display mode automatically shifted to the display, and at the display we will see the waveform at the CRO. So after capturing the waveform, to reset this to take the another waveform, we can press reset. And this is the CN1 connector which will be used to connect the motor. So we will move on to the motor section. So this is our motor. In this full section of DC control, there is the motor connected in the middle part, and this is the tacho generator for the feedback, and this is the sorry, this is the TACO generator for the feedback, and this is the potentiometer reference voltage or reference degrees, which will be similar as the reference which is at the kit. So you can also see the different angles through this window, at the DC position control. Here you can see the different values of this window here. So this is at the 30 degree position, so this can move the rotate at the 360 degree, and this is the positive and negative feedback TACO generator switch. So it will be required as per the requirement and the practicals. Now we will move on to the manual section. So this is the user manual to perform working at this kit, and to describe the different parts in the theoretical, and also some patch codes to connect the inputs. So now we move on to the experiment of this DC control trainer. So we will understand the basic position control of a second order system. The formula or calculating the basic second order equation is given over here, which is the GS is equal to omega n square upon s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. So omega is the damping, the zeta is the damping ratio, and omega n is the undamped natural frequency, which can be calculated. So this is the basic circuitry of the diagram. So after calculations, we will find out the waveform on the CRO as this normalized step response of the second order system, but we will find out the XY output of this calculated waveform, and we will also calculate the underdamped case. In the underdamped case, the zeta will be 0 to in between 0 to 1, and in the overdamped case, the zeta is greater than 1, and in the critical damped case, the zeta is equal to 1. So these are the different second order equations which are provided in the manual. So for practical purpose at the experimental work, we will find out first the manual operation for position control, and then we will check the step response of position control without TACO generator feedback and then with TACO generator feedback. So these are the different steps given in the experimental work. For this, we will first power on this kit like this. So as I power on this kit, you can see the power LED has started glowing and the DPM is showing at the zero value. Now we will connect this motor connector at the CN1 9 pin connector here. So this will be the motor's connector. So as we connect the motor here, now first press the reset key. So the display will be shift on the display, so that right now the waveform which is already in the circuit or the waveform card is now cleared by pressing the reset. And now we will shift to the mode. This will shift the LED to the capture mode. Now as I give the step input, the waveform will be captured through the waveform generator card, and we will be observe the waveform at the CRO, and also we will see the motor will be rotate with the step input. So for step input, the step input is fixed from the VS, which is the internal supply. So this is the 2.5 or 2.6. the negative will be the technical reasons, so you can avoid this negative value. So the values are only for the reference. Now make sure the first, when we use this TACO generator feedback, the toggle switch is at the positive position here. And now we will see, as I give the step input, the motor will rotate and give the one signal. So we will on the step input, and you can see the motor starts rotating in some time, and after a step input over, the motor stops, and display will, the LED of waveform generator will shift to display. Here you can see I will repeat the process as I off the step input and reset the waveform. So after resetting, we will again check the waveform and process. So press mode, the capture LED is glowing. So I will give the step input. The motor rotates and the display will be automatically changes this LED to display. You can see now we can see the output as the LED shifted from capture to display. So our waveform has been captured and the waveform generator is at display mode. So now we will connect the CRO to observe the waveform, which what will be the waveform response of this step command. So for this we have connected the CRO. The ground will be common for both in the XY mode. For the first we will check the waveform of X. So this is the sawtooth waveform of the fixed signal. Now we will connect also the Y channel. So there are two waveforms now, and we will switch this mode to the XY mode of the CRO. So this is the output of the graphical representation of the frequency or the control system position control response. So this is the XY mode's output here. You can see and observe at the CRO. So that will be clear when I press the reset button from the kit. You can see as I press the reset, the response is clear. Now the blank XY direction is giving at the CRO. Now we will first check and measure the different outputs for the positive control through step command. So now we will follow the position control through continuous command. For this we will follow these steps. So for this we will ensure that the command switch is at off position. So first we will off this command switch. It is right now at on position. Now I will off this. Now we will use this command potentiometer and rotate this command potentiometer in small steps. But before this, make sure both the knobs of gain and tacho generator feedback should be at some of the value. It should not be 0, it is more than 0 or 2, 3 in between. Now we can see our knob is at 90 degree position right now. You can see the knob is at 90 degree position. Now as I move this knob to 110 degree, which is the 20 degree deflections, now also we have connected this patch code from VS to VR. So this is the potentiometer command reference which will be showing at the input. So this is now 1.15 volts, and the potentiometer is at between 90 and 100 degree. Also at the potentiometer of the motor you can observe this is at also around 90 degree here. So this is the 90 degree. Now as I increase this potentiometer from 90 to 100 or 200, 120, so I have increased this to 120, but there is in some error due to this. So the deflection is only at 110. As I increase the potentiometer from 120 degree to 150 degree, it's also run as following command and goes to about 150 degree. So every time measure the reading for different values of degrees. So as I increase this now from 30 degree, from 60 degree and 90 degree as well. So from different degrees you can measure the output or the potentiometer reference at the motor side and measure the difference of input and output. You will find out an observation table and write down these values in observation table and find out the different degrees variation, which is the delta theta r and delta theta vr minus v naught. So you will find the difference of vr. So this is the closed loop continuous command. Now we will move on to the position control through step command. For this we will make sure the TECO generator feedback is at negative position. Now we will adjust the VR around 0. It will automatically come at 0 in some of the steps. So this is the 350 degree that I have set, and it is near about the 350. At the 0 position the voltage goes to 0, so that's why you have to remain this sum of the voltage, which is 0.5 or 8. So the value, sum of the voltage value, will be given to the position command, and this will be stopped at 10. It will take a complete rotation some of the times, and now it is stopped at around 0 to 10 degree. This is the 10 degree. Now we will set the KA gain to 2, but the KA gain is about, should be 4 to 3. So the value will give some the K, the positive gain or forward gain. Now we will change the different commands from 0 to 70 and wait for some time. After calculation the output will occur and motor starts rotating. So at this position the motor is not rotating, so we have to increase the gain. So now we will increase the gain to 5, and we can see motor has been started and try to reach about the 70 degree position. So this is the 60 degree position that motor have been reached, which is showing the output. Here you can see this is the 60 degree. As I set the value of about 70 degree, now I will set this value to 130 degree. You can see it is reaching almost about 130 degree. So this is the step command input from negative, from the reference command. Now we will increase and note down the values for different KA and make the observation table for different values of KA. At 7 you can see the speed also increases while controlling. Now we will do the closed loop study. For this we will increase the TECO generator, so the value of TECO generator will give the closed loop and complete the closed loop of voltage. So we will also find out the voltage here. So this is the 3.1 volt in positive we are getting from the TECO generator feedbacks. Now as I move the command potentiometer to reverse 140 degree, the motor starts rotating and try to reach about 140 degree. So this is the TECO generator command. The motor control and stops at some of the positions and give the command, which is the 290 degree. and motor try again and again to reach till the accuracy is not provided. So as we increase the taco gain higher than the forward gain, it will rotate more time to reach the accuracy, which is through this we will find the error signal or the steady state error. Also the observation and calculation are given in this user manual. So first we have calculated the steady state error in the with the taco generator feedback, and now we will calculate this with the taco generator feedback. So for this we will set the gain about 7 and taco generator's output should be 5, which should be less than the forward gain. Now we will change the position of this potentiometer command to 330 degree, and you can see the motor has been reached about 340 degree. Yeah, so as I increase the command to 30 degree, so motor trying to reach about 30 degree, so as it not get the position, so it will rotate to full 360 degree round and try to reach the 30 degree input. So that's how we control the DC position controlling by different modes for capturing the waveform. We will change this mode to capture, and after capturing it will show the output in some time. For capturing the waveform we have to give the step input. So this is the step input, motor rotates, and after some time it will turn to display. So this is the step input which you can see in the graph, which is the almost same graph of typical step response of a position control system. This is the almost similar graph which is also showing in the manual we are. So this is the theoretical and ideal graph. Here you can find out the dead zone also. So this is the dead zone, this is the increasing of ramp input which is showing at the CRO. So that's how we calculate the different values or different steady states error and compute the different values for different commands. So this is the DC position control trainer for different purposes to understand the second order control system. So that's how we calculate the DC position control trainer and operate the DC position control trainer through the different practical responses. So while performing the practical, you find any difficulty, you can contact to Tezca Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.